Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise.
Welcome back to Spotlight. I'm your host, Jane Wernette, and I'm joined now by Dan Jurjevic and Kevin Kobe of Naperville Response for Veterans. So welcome.
Thank you, Jane.
Thanks. Hey, we're always excited to talk to you, and I'm going to start off right away with you, Dan. Tell us a little bit about Naperville Response for Veterans.
Sure. Naperville Response for Veterans is a 501c3 organization. We are an entire volunteer board of directors. We serve veterans that are in financial need with home improvement projects. And the home improvement projects are like the most dire, not cosmetic, not superficial. These would be handicap accessibility, major structural issues with homes, holes in roofs, broken windows, things of that nature.
Okay, so things that are really about both the safety and the health of
exactly
your veterans, right?
Right? Yeah. And accessibility.
Right, yeah. And they're usually the last ones to ask for help, right?
They certainly are. You know, yeah. One of our biggest challenges is finding the veterans that need our assistance. There's a lot of outreach involved in doing that because veterans are more inclined to help others and not ask for help for themselves. So.
Yeah.
That's one of our challenges.
Okay. Well, Kevin, talk a little bit about that. How do you go about reaching the veterans?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. You know, we've really focused more on, you know, dealing with the VFWs and the American Legions and kind of ingratiating ourselves with those groups and getting some trust with them because, kind of like Dan was saying, you know, veterans have served other people, and they're not the type of people that often like to ask for help. And so what we found is that the best way to get, you know, a good, strong referral and a trusted source is to go through an actual veteran. So
yeah.
A lot of the work that we've done has, you know, we're constantly trying to market ourselves, you know, through our website and doing different events and things like that. But really the strongest connection is with the veteran.
Yeah, and I think, you know, we have some wonderful, wonderful organizations in our community with the VFW and
yep.
American Legion and stuff that, you know, want to do good work. And so that seems like a great way to partner, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've both got the same, in some ways, the same mission going at it in different directions.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Dan, talk about, so when you've identified a veteran and now you've got to figure out how to get the project done, talk a little bit about how you set up the work and the projects.
Sure. Our process is, you know, we as a board of directors are going to review applications. We have a construction committee that will look at the work and determine the cost and get proposals for the work from licensed professionals. We have a veterans committee that's going to actually meet with the veteran, get the information that we need to ensure that they are in fact a veteran, that they are in fact in financial need. And really it's a simple process of putting it to a vote after we have all the costs associated with it from the licensed professionals that we partner with. We almost always approve every project. I would say that we always do approve every project if it's a qualified candidate. And, you know, we're fortunate that we have great partnerships with a lot of local contractors and suppliers where, you know, the cost of the jobs are heavily discounted and a lot of times they're donated. So in addition to the efficiencies that we have with our donation dollars being a 100% volunteer board, we're also getting the benefit of large discounts and donations on the actual build side from the suppliers and the subcontractors. So it works out well.
Yeah, and I would imagine you spend a lot of time cultivating those relationships, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Is it hard? Do you find, it's such a wonderful mission. Is it hard to find folks that want to step up
on
that?
It's one of the nice things. It's almost overwhelming the outreach that you get from different, you know, plumbers and carpenters and suppliers that want to be involved, that want to help out. And you kind of keep a database of those folks and say, hey, I'll get in touch with you when we have a project that fits the description for how you can help us. And that is one of the wonderful things that we see is there's so much support that we get outside of our board of directors, outside of our normal group of supporters, new people every day that contact us that want to get involved.
That's great. That's wonderful. That's a great testament to the work that you're doing.
Yeah.
Kevin, talk a little bit about the funds because, mm-hmm. you know, one of the things is that this work is done for free, right?
Correct.
So how do you raise the money to support that?
Yeah, so we have, you know, a couple different avenues, but for the most part, you know, we'll get annual donations from people. We'll get just kind of one-off people that have just randomly heard about our organization and like the mission and want to help out. You know, but then we also will get, we'll run the gamut. We have people, we have a child that just gave us, you know, money from their lemonade stand. And then we run, you know, we go all the way up to a 400-person, what we call our Cheers event, which is our big gala every year. So we have kind of a few main fundraisers.
Okay. A little more about those.
Yeah, sure. We do a luncheon every spring, which we just had, where we have anywhere from 4 to 450 people that attend. It's more of a, we really want to just thank the veterans for their service. So we oftentimes will have, I think this year we had almost 200 veterans show up, mm-hmm. And they get a free lunch and
nice.
Just some recognition of thanks from the community. We are about to do our Tournament of Champions golf outing, where we pit the three of the local
country clubs.
Yeah. Thanks, Dan, with Niverville Country Club, White Eagle, and Crest Creek, and they just basically they play some rounds of golf and they raise money for our organization.
Nice.
And then the last one is our Cheers event, which is our kind of our big gala that we do every year.
Yeah. Now I'm going to ask you, Dan. I think I already know the answer, but I'm going to ask you anyway. How are you doing this year versus last year? Because I was at the Cheers event this past November.
So. Well, really, I mean, over the course of the last 3 years, I'd say there's been very steady growth in. You know, if we're looking at 2017 compared to 2016, you know, the attendance at our events was exponentially higher. The amount of money that we've raised, the amount of money that we've also been able to spend on veterans is probably twice as much as we had done in previous years. So
that's wonderful. Now, what do you put that down to?
It's just a testament to the organization's hard work. You know, we had put a challenge out a year and a half ago to do more, raise more money, and take on more veteran projects. We didn't ever want to feel like we were restricted in terms of how many veterans we could help based on how much money we were able to raise. Because I think that if you work hard enough, if you're creative enough, living and working and reaching out to a community like Naperville, you know, there's always an opportunity to grow your organization. And everybody on the board of directors, all the different committees that are involved, have all done their part. Everyone from public relations, which Kevin's the chair of, getting the message out, the events chairs that put on the events that we do, the fundraisers that we do throughout the year, the construction committee, the guys that actually have to execute these jobs. I mean, we're doing over 40 jobs a year, and for guys who actually have day jobs in addition to manning that post.
Right, this is not a full-time job.
Correct.
This is what you're doing is you're giving service part.
Right, and all these folks are volunteers, so the entire board of directors are volunteers. It's just there's a genuine passion, I think, in amongst the group for what we do and what our mission is that gives people that inkling to work harder and to do more. And you know, we're seeing the result of everybody's hard work right now, so that's great.
Yeah, that is wonderful. Well, and I think certainly that enthusiasm, it breeds success, and then that breeds more success, right? Because people kind of get behind it. You get that sense that you can accomplish something.
Absolutely.
And that just feeds on itself.
Yep.
As we wrap up, Kevin, talk a little bit about the Cheers event and what's coming up this year.
Yeah, the Cheers event, we have it's usually the first week in November, so this year it's November 1st. And yeah, like Dan was saying, we've grown significantly in the past couple of years. I think last year we had around 420 people. This year we're hoping to get upwards of 500. So that's an ambitious goal, but we have a great speaker that we were able to secure. His name is Dr. Sujit Bose, mm-hmm. and he's a very well-known veterans advocate.
Okay,
and so he's. He has a very strong online following, and he's been on all the major news networks. So, we expect that to be there's a lot of energy with him.
Also, a Naperville Central graduate.
That's
too,
right.
So
yeah,
he's a local guy.
That's fantastic.
That's going on to do tremendous things.
Yeah. So nice to be able to hold up somebody within the own community that is doing that. That's great.
So we're really excited. Just to we've already started the planning, and the main thing is we're looking. We have such a local group of people that's always supporting us. So I don't think the ticket sales is necessarily as important as, we're looking for sponsorships, we're looking for those those corporate donations that we really want to walk into the event and know that it's going to be a success because we have a bunch of sponsorships behind us already.
Okay. Well, I have a sense with your enthusiasm that's not going to be too hard. So kudos to you for all the good work. I know that you're putting in a lot of hours and a lot of heart to bring this through, and I know that our veterans certainly locally really, really appreciate the work that you're doing. So thank you.
Thank you, Jane.
If you would like to learn more about Naperville Response for Veterans, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break, but stay tuned. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.